I am Iron Man.
Thomas here with Much Props, gonna give you another how-to video. It is time once again for another iteration to my mashup between the Knights Templar and Iron Man build. I have built the pauldrons, the gorge, the sword, the shield, the helmet. Now it's time to build some chainmail / scale mail sleeves using some of Ben Eadie and Stephanie Chan's scale mail and chain mail, which you can now purchase online on their store, foamarmory.com. And that's the game plan. So without further ado, let's build some sleeves. Medieval style.
When you order a package of chainmail from Foam Armory, it comes in a nice stack of 10 sheets per pack. There are 10 strips of chainmail per sheet, so that means a total of 100 strings of chainmail. They're pre-perforated, so literally all you have to do is pull the strip out from the sheet and then push out all the holes of foam. I keep the dots for rivets and other small circle details for later. How about an epic montage of an hour or two I spent pulling out strips and popping out holes? Let's get into my more epic voice.
One man, a foam fanatic, evaluator of EVA, a foam smith on a mission to construct the most comfortable lightweight chain mail sleeve ever conceived. As his fingers dart across the perforation, he contemplates if all this time spent will be worth it or even necessary in the end. Zoning out on some anime, he pushes through with his fingers cramping, foam flying everywhere, periodically brushing off the piles of scrap and stack strip after strip after strip of epic foam chainmail from the legendary Ben Eadie and Stephanie Chan. With his end in sight and rivets burying his hand on his work surface, he finally is finished. No, wait, he forgot he also has to pop out the scale wheel too. Alright, Cut the montage here. That's enough. Let's just skip over the rest of me popping out these things.
The scale mail has two different strips. One strip with the holes that are even with the scale, and the other holes line up in between the scale. This allows you to stagger your scale instead of them being in a straight line. I'm going to make a strip go up the center of my arm to match my pauldrons that I've made previously. So I have four scales in one stack and three in another, all with full circles. Assembly is easy. Bend the circle in half and push it through the next row. I have long arms, so the length of rows that I need is about 63. You're gonna have to measure your own arm and figure out that number for yourself. I've had lots of people point out in my other chainmail videos that the mail is facing the wrong way. It should interlock with a horizontal, not vertical alignment. This way the mail bends with the body contours instead of just, I guess, being stiff. It just so happens that I figured this would be easier in assembly, so I'm gonna put it the right way. Hooray! So I pushed the chainmail through the circles of the scale mail all the way up. It took a little finessing, but I finally got the hang of it and put both sides on both strips through. I then put 13 rows of chainmail on each side of the scale mail. The assembly will curl up a little bit, but we'll fix it later with some heat treatment. The length of my arm is about 28 inches from shoulder to wrist. It took about 25 rings around my wrist plus 4 scale mail, however you want to take that. The length takes up just a little less than 3 strings of scale due to the length of my arm. So I estimated that the base is going to be about 75 pieces of this chainmail. Then I had to take into account that my bicep is twice the size of my wrist, so size is going to have to get bigger as it goes further up from 8.5 inches to about 17 inches or so. So I expect that that probably adds another 25 strips maybe. With all that measuring, I estimate that I have about 100 strips of chainmail per arm. So 2 packs of chainmail should cover it, maybe get 3 just in case if you've got big arms. I used a little more than 30 strips of the scale mail, which is about half of 1 pack. I super glued strips of 3 together to go the full length of my arm. To get everything to lay down flat and sit right, we need to heat form this just a little bit. I used some 1-2-3 blocks to weigh down parts as I heated the pieces up and then moved my way up the sleeve to flatten it out. This is where I got really nervous. I wasn't sure if it was gonna work, and I'd spent several hours to this point weaving these long sheets. Here's my thought. I know that the wrist will at least fit, but I need to make it bigger as it gets to my bicep in order for it to fit at, you know, my shoulder area. I push the circles through the opposite side and one by one super glue one side onto the back of the other. As I work my way up, I'm constantly trying it on. Eventually I get to where I need to add. So when the fit gets a little snug, I add another row on each side, super gluing the first circle on the back of my connection. Once I get under my arm, I stop and then cut a curve in the chainmail up to the point of the shoulder. I'm sure this makes absolutely no sense, but you'll see it in the next screen or two. Think of how a jacket sleeve would be shaped. That's what I'm going for. To secure the ends and give myself a surface for strapping later, I need to reinforce the edge. I put down some contact cement on the outside on the back of a 1-inch wide strip of 2mm EVA foam and let it set up. When the surfaces are no longer wet, they are ready to tack together. Once the outside is secure, I do basically the same thing with the inside and am sandwiching the chainmail between these two pieces of 2mm foam. After trying on the sleeve, I realized that the shape on the top was not laying down like I wanted it to. This, of course, stressed me out again because here I am with not just one sleeve now, but two that I've worked to this point. And then eventually I had kind of an aha moment. When I want to curve apart on a helmet, the piece has to have a dart on it. So I reinforced the inside of my chainmail and scale mail where the seam line is so that I can cut a dart. Cut along the scale mail strip and then glue those together. To hide my adjustment, I just simply glue the strip over the top of the scale mail. The armpit was having a similar problem with laying flat, so I cut it right in the middle and then just overlapped the two pieces into a V shape. To add a little detail and tie it in with the design of the rest of my armor, I'm adding some strips of 4mm and 2mm EVA on the edge of the armpit cuffs. This further thickens the edge and reinforces it more. Here is one baggie of several that I have holes that I've popped out in. Time to repurpose some of them as rivets along the armpit cuff. I use my hobby knife to easily pick them up and apply them with a little super glue on the back. I use my thumb as a quick judgment for spacing between each rivet. Two coats of Plasti-Dip. I'm going to paint the scale mail first and try an easier method than several coats of acrylic paint like I did with the previous sets of armor pieces. I tape off the scale and hit with some red spray paint instead. Any overspray, I went back and touched it up with black once I finished. For the chainmail, I decided to make it match the chainmail that are on some of my other pieces, which are gold. There is a little on the side of my helmet that's already painted this way. I'm using some gold rub and buff and a dry brush technique using an old chip brush. I just hit the high points of the chainmail and allow the recesses to stay sparsely hit. This gives the appearance of older metal. I'm almost out of this tube, so I'm praying that I don't run out and have to run to the hospital hobby store, so I'm trying to be very cautious about using too much. I am also out of shoe polish at this point, so I'm going to dirty up the red scale with some brown and black acrylic paint. Using a wet brush, I sloppily mix the two colors together and slather it onto the scale. Then I take a dry paper towel and simply dab off parts of it to partially leave the paint in certain areas. Here's another guess, because I really don't know what I'm doing, and you're seeing my first thought. I wasn't sure if it was going to work, but I decided to use elastic strapping to secure them to me. I know it wouldn't be authentic of the time, but this is a mashup of Iron Man and a Knights Templar, so it really doesn't make sense already. Plus, I'm kind of guessing that this is going to get covered up by the gorget anyways when I have a costume on. I cut small strips of 1-inch elastic banding and glue it in a V-shape on the edge of my sleeve. One goes at the top, just off center of the top of my shoulder towards the back, and the other piece is a few inches down further on the back. Then reinforce the connection with some small strips of 2mm EVA, just like I do with my mask to keep it secure. I will use some 1/2-inch banding in a cross strapping placement to connect each side so that it is adjustable and easy to fit if you get the length wrong.
And we are finished. Here is the end result. I am super pumped with the way they turned out. I've actually had these sitting in my man cave for a while, but because of other builds, it kind of kept getting pushed back, and I'm glad I finally sat down and finished them. The trickiest part for me was trying to figure out how this would lay flatter up on my shoulder, and it really did help cutting that wedge out and then gluing the strip continuing up, which made it almost seamless. I mean, if you get close, you can kind of tell, but I really love the way this thing turned out, and the simple reinforcement here to keep the parts from pulling off. I didn't know if the strapping was going to be a sure thing either, but it actually worked out pretty good because it's pulling in that diagonal direction. It leaves it nice and taut, and I think that most of it will be hidden under the gorget. If not, I'm planning on putting a cape back there, so the cape will probably cover it as well. But yeah, maybe you will try and make one of these yourselves and impress your friends with your ability to fake chainmail, scale mail look, and it still be super light and comfortable and bendable and super awesome. Can't wait. Maybe I'll get some.
Yay!
And inevitably, they're gonna ask you, how'd you make that? You can give them one of these, tell them, much props. Thank you, Stephanie Chan and Ben Eadie. This stuff is awesome. I am getting close to the end. And let me put this thing on. See, it's not that hard to get on by yourself. It's the taking it off. Can you help me? Here, just grab the straps. Grab the straps.
If you enjoy what I do here on YouTube and want to see me continue to build awesome things like this, please consider joining my Patreon with these awesome people and help me create a bigger, better, more creative community.